There's some incredibly rare footage, and you know, it's a treat to be able to show you all this this material. This is just the tip of the iceberg. You know, at the beginning of the project, we had this notion of creating kind of a digital presidential library in the mall. And there's over a million items in his archive, spanning that 50-year career in here. About half a million photos, and lots of memorabilia, lyrics, and outfits, and things like that, audio, new visual tape, all different formats. And then I have a personal favorite that's in the archive that I think you guys will see a bit of. It's the set list, the last set list for the Beatles' last concert. I know it is on the screen. And it was taped to the back of Paul's iconic coffin face for many years. And one day, he switched bases and played a Rickenbacker for a while with Hopper. And Hopper came back out. And one day, his guitar tech, just a few years ago, asked Paul, said, "Well, what is that?" And Paul looked at it and sort of scratched his head. I think that's the set list from Candlestick. So Keith Smith is his tech. Took out the tweezers and carefully pulled it off and put it in an archive. So there it is, literally a scrap of history. But now with this project, we can share with everyone. So it's a sort of fun, exciting example of a scrap of history. But the whole thing requires a very comprehensive conversion from analog to digital, full tagging and indexing, and a very secure private cloud, which we can then move over to a public cloud. And HP understood that, and it's an issue a lot of media companies face, any company that deals with zeros and ones faces, and that's pretty much everyone. So.
Well, those are precious assets, and many of our customers and audience also have that same type of business need, where there's some vital assets that are valuable to you. So what were some of the considerations or the key requirements that went into as you thought about building out this project?
Well, we have this, the private cloud piece, which is basically everything. And then we also needed to build out the public cloud, the power through Paul McCartney.com.